Los Angeles, California, Sunday morning, 6 a.m. Here, each spring, a group of singularly dedicated people gather to prepare a block party to fight cancer. In the climax of a year of constant effort, homemaker and attorney, clerk and industrialist roll up their sleeves to create this unique event, raising almost $1 million to help find a cure for cancer within the body's own immune system. Their organization's name mirrors the long-term commitment each member has made. Concern Foundation for Cancer Research. As part of the foundation's totally democratic process, any member is welcome to join the grants committee, and after intensive study and evaluating fund requests, help decide to which doctors and laboratories monies will be granted. Because Concern is virtually an all-volunteer foundation, over 90% of every dollar raised will be given to leading research facilities across the world. In Stockholm, Dr. George Klein, former head of the Nobel Prize Committee for Medicine, has long worked closely with Concern.
I think the people I met from Concern have an extraordinary dedication to supporting this type of research, which is really wonderful. And I think we are very, very grateful for their confidence in us, because that is what makes us go.
It was Concern that helped Dr. David Weiss create the now-renowned Lautenberg Center for Immunology in Jerusalem.
Concern has been consistently, from the beginning to the present, our single major contributor, and I would say conservatively that at least three quarters, if not more, of everything done in our research programs at the Lautenberg Center has been funded and is funded today by Concern Foundation.
For Dr. Gloria Heppner in Detroit, Concern provided support at the very beginning of her career in cancer research.
Concern is unique in that the members of that organization really are knowledgeable and really care about learning about cancer research. It's not just that you go to a party and smile. That's not what your interaction is with Concern Foundation as opposed to everything else I do. As a matter of fact, the people there really want to know what you do. They want to understand why you do it. They read themselves. They know a lot. This is not a superficial organization. It's really a sort of an intellectual group of people. And believe me, that is totally unique in my experience for fundraising support groups.
For Dr. Malcolm Mitchell, the hope of finding an inoculation against the deadly melanoma has come closer to reality with the help of Concern.
Concern sends delegations to find out what's going on. There are people who actually enter the lab, who actually go through, into the clinic, who find out what is actually being done. Not because they're checking on you, because they're really thoroughly interested in what you're doing and how they are affecting what you're doing.
Indeed, it was in Los Angeles in 1968 that 14 young couples were moved to create Concern after the loss of a friend to cancer.
As we watched Beverly get sicker and sicker from the very beginning, she knew she was going to die of cancer because every female in her family had died of cancer. But she thought she'd be much older, not 38, when she finally passed away. But this is the first time that a contemporary of mine had been hit by a dreaded disease. And we wanted to do whatever we could to make her feel comfortable and make her live on in all of us.
My involvement began with Beverly Woolman, who was my patient. She was dying of breast cancer, and she is the patient who requested that we start an organization. All of her friends came to me, and we sat down, and we started Concern. And we elected early to stay in one particular area, cancer immunology, because we knew that we would be too spread out if we tried to enter all the areas of cancer research.
A bold idea, for cancer immunology was brand new at that time.
Very close to her, a man who doesn't live in Los Angeles now, just heard about it.
In another basic strategy, Concern has acted on the belief that by providing funds to the most talented young researchers today, it will hasten the great discoveries of tomorrow.
Okay, would someone please make a motion regarding Alan Fry of New York University Medical Center?
Yeah. I move we accept the CV that we just received and we approve the grant.
I second.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye. Anybody?
In research laboratories around the world, many of the most advanced new ideas have come from young doctors for whom financing is often scarce.
Concern supported our research, our initial research, for 2 years without really asking for too much evidence or pre-existing data. Other agencies wouldn't have allowed such a situation to occur. Now that we could start the project with the support of Concern, we were able, with our preliminary data, to compete.
The major funding organizations in the country, such as the National Cancer Institute and other large funding organizations, won't fund research projects unless it is demonstrated to them that there is a high likelihood of success for a research project. So, in a sense, you have to almost have done the project to get enough data to show that the project is going to succeed. So the scientists are caught in a catch-22 situation. And this problem is amplified when there are young researchers involved, merely because they've been in the field a shorter amount of time and have less of an opportunity to develop a track record.
One of the things I really do here at the foundation is work on getting support for young investigators, because that's the future. Future for cancer research, it's the future for research in general, it's the economic future of our country. If we do not keep bringing in young people into science and technology and rejuvenate what's going on and provide for the future, we won't have one.
Research is it's a very demanding job. It's not an easy job. I mean, there are no hours, and there's maybe even more difficult if you are a woman, if you have a family, if you have to work very hard in the lab and then go home and take care of your family, and then when everything is ready, you have to go back to work.
I think the most important thing about Concern for me, who's a young physician, is that it funds people with ideas. It gives people a way of getting started. The way medicine's evolving and cancer research is evolving, people want to hit on the big ideas, and nobody wants to start funding people to start out.
Despite difficulties exploring the medical frontiers, Concern's central search remains focused on cancer immunology, on learning how the body's natural defenses must sometimes be alerted to fight a deceptive foe. Only recently captured on film, these unique scanning electron microscope photographs for the first time reveal human immune system cells doing battle with cancer. It was the ancient Greeks who first observed that people who survived the first attack of a disease were often immune to it thereafter. It is believed that today many develop cancer but successfully fight off the disease. It is also believed that immunology, the body's own natural defense system, will provide the key which one day will set us free from an enemy that wears many changing disguises.
There is a quality, not just a level, but a quality of dedication and commitment to the goal that Concern set itself, namely the fight against cancer, and specifically to support the immunological arm or the dimension of cancer research. The dedication and commitment are qualitatively unique. I've never seen that in any other group of people.
She was at the peak of her career when cancer struck her. And her public
such dedication often wins others to join the struggle. Here Quincy Jones celebrates the memory of singer Minnie Riperton, hosting a concert in which Stevie Wonder donated his talents to raise more than $250,000 for Concern.
Bringing us closer to a cure for breast cancer.
Cancer this year will affect over 1 million people who will be diagnosed with the disease for the first time. And it will affect 3 out of 4 families in the United States. And so it makes its presence known among our family and our friends.
Our network throughout the world, Stockholm, Israel, Paris, United States, New York, Los Angeles, Michigan, the best cancer centers in the world are networking with Concern Foundation.
I love my sister very much, and I respected her views. So when she became involved in Concern, of course, I wanted to be involved also, because it was something that she wanted.
My mother died of leukemia 10 years ago, and I've since been looking for a vehicle to vent my frustration.
I don't think that I'm the one who can be fighting cancer. I'm the one who chose to take this avenue to direct my frustrations about the disease and watching friends suffer from the disease.
In the continuing battle against cancer, the members of Concern have placed their private griefs into public service. They have enlisted the help of major scientists around the world and summoned the adventurous minds of dedicated young researchers to explore the frontiers of a tragic affliction that affects countless lives around the globe. It is Concern's loyalty to people, wherever they may be, that is playing a central role in relieving so much suffering through a deeper understanding of an ever-changing, ever-threatening enemy.